Talking about the pros, it connect people and we can easily connect to everyone, and we see that we have platforms like LinkedIn. It seems that we are living in two worlds. One is the real world and other is the virtual world. Social media indeed has today become a new world altogether. We'll find everyone there, and the good part about social media is that it has given voice to the voiceless. Social media is basically a technology that immensely gives us the advantage of connecting people, and it has removed all the barriers, all the distances, and we can connect anyone who is far away from us. And especially when it comes to the pandemic time, we have seen how important role it has played for all of us to make us stay together and listen to our friends and families and support them in grief. Now when we come to social media, it has given as I said, voice to the voiceless. And it has become a platform for a lot of campaigns that we have seen in past and we keep on seeing on daily basis. We have seen that this is the same platform that gave rise to the Me Too movement, which was a voice to the women that they have faced the discrimination against them in their careers and the kind of harassment that they have faced. And we have also seen that it can also be a deteriorating factor. When it comes to, we see that it is used for political agendas by a lot of political parties to spread their agendas and their negatives and rumors. So there, it has both the sides. It has its cons and it has its pros. Talking about the pros, it connect people and we can easily connect to everyone. And we see that we have platforms like LinkedIn who also help us to get jobs. Second advantage is that it gives voice to the voiceless. Third advantage is that it makes people aware about the current affairs and current campaigns that are going on. And it earlier what used to happen is that whatever the politician is saying, we used to believe it, but now we have these people who can post everything in social media, and we can provide the other people to know the truth. Like we have seen in the case of farmers' protest, it gave a voice to a lot of people who came together. Now, a fourth thing is that it is a new technology which is giving job to a lot of people. Now, we see that a lot of people are employed in this, and this technology is providing a lot of jobs. Now, talking about its cons, the first thing is that it is usually used these days by the political parties for their agendas and for spreading their ideologies. Second thing is that it is a platform now today used as a platform to spread rumors and fake news. Now we see that we have this technologies coming up that can even fake a picture or fake everything. So it's very hard for us to believe as to what is right or what is wrong. And the third thing is that it actually can have a deteriorating impact on people's life also. Like we have seen in Me Too movement, there are people who, as in our law it said, it's until proven guilty the person is not a criminal. So in this, this goes topsy-turvy, because we can see that once the accusation has been put on someone, and the social media completely ruins his or her image, and which is a kind of a mental pressure that happens. Even we see that social media has also become a kind of a peer pressure for students, then they are very busy in getting the number of likes in their pictures rather than they are busy in getting the maximum marks. It also impacts their concentration power, and we can see that because of this they are not able to concentrate at a board for more than 3 minutes. Now, talking about the other disadvantage, it is having causing issues like mental health issue as well. Now, what is the solution for all this? I would say that there has to be a solution, could be provided by us only to ourselves. We have to limit our usage of social media. We have to decide the time span, and this has to be done for the children by their parents. And as youth, as sensible individuals, we can limit our time. We can double check the information that's provided to us in the social media before reacting to it. So we have recently come up with this the statement also that there every reaction is having an equal and opposite reaction plus an overreaction on social media. So we do not have to overreact. We have to check our facts, and it's our responsibility for ourselves. And third thing is that using social media is important, but we should not use it to impress people. We should use it to impact people. Thank you.